Let's get it. Hop off a 16 passenger. This a G5. No, this not a Challenger.
Big one.
I keep some members with me in the fridge. The coat seats, they some cannibals.
Eaters.
They like to get geek. Drink a whole bottle, wake up and repeat.
Damn.
She took a look, mixed it with the chill out. Now she say she saying 3D.
Wow.
I go in the jungle and they got a coat. I bet I come out with a meme.
I bet I
do this shit for the fam. Cause this shit bigger than me.
Yo. Okay. We are back, ladies and gentlemen. We're back for another week of shit. Here we go. I don't want to say I'm going to blitz through this, but sorry for the delay as well. Christmas was big, and then work and everything. I've just been tired. I'm still kind of tired. Got the little morning cafecito. It's a go. But, let's get right fucking into it for the comic pickups of the week. We're going to start with... So, this was another week of slaps. Like, everything here... Let me see, I even have them all written down here as well. Everything here is pretty... So this week was pretty on point. It was pretty good. Like, also, I think, what is it? I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I have 6 issues, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Half of them are Spawn variants. We're still in December. Even though next week's podcast is going to be in January, it's still pick up from the previous week. It's still a December pickup. All Spawn variants. Not all, but I'm going to try to see what I can get from there. You know what I'm saying? Since they're all Spawn variants, though, I'm going to get straight into it. So, my boy Scotty Young and Brett Bean hitting us with I Hate Fairyland, issue number 2. So, our fucking girl Grootcher, she's finally in Fairyland, the billionaire center with like an aide to get into Fairyland. The art is crazy. This has to be like a short run. I don't see this like going super long. This issue was better than the last one, honestly. Better than issue 1. But thank God, because I might have been thinking about dropping. I'd give this issue a 7. I Hate Fairyland. We'll get a 7. I Hate Fairyland is getting a 7. And then we're going to get right into Go Go Power Rangers! Go Go Power Rangers! Power Rangers by Melissa Flores. This cover looks like it was done by Dan Mora. No, it wasn't. Possibly, because Dan Mora does do some Power Ranger covers. Power Rangers is picking up. It's good. I'm going to get into a whole episode of just me talking about Power Ranger issues, because holy shit, thank you, Jose, for putting me on, because I want to go in depth more into them. And next week, it's issue 1 of Power Rangers and Ninja Turtles crossover. So that's going to be dope as fuck. Dan Mora's doing art. It looks amazing. It's Power Rangers. I'm giving 7 as well. 7. Still above I Hate Fairyland. Spider-Man The Lost Hunt. Holy shit. So, Jose mentioned a good point in our group chat. Mainline Spider-Man is like, it's like pulling teeth. I'm only reading just to read. I don't even pick them up, the physical issues, because I want to start from like an arc or somewhere. But it's just like, what is happening? James DeMatteis, I think his name is. He's really doing an amazing job in this event. He's just doing a great job. I want to rate the entire event and go like a full summary when it's done. But yeah, I'm gonna give that one 7.5, pushing eight. Next on the list, my boy Donnie Cates and Ryan Stegman hitting us with Vanish. Look at this Spawn variant though. Shit is dope. Also, did you see the Spawn variant for I Hate Fairyland? I didn't even go into detail about that. She's like Santa Claus and he's sitting on her lap. Fucking funny. Mad funny. But the Spawn variant for Vanish is so dope. Like, this cover is amazing. This shit is so dope. I hate the fucking glare. Anyways. Or, if I should... Nope, glare's just still there. This is getting heavy. It's getting heavy. This boy is looking for everybody who was part of Vanish, who killed his civilization and killed his family when he was young. He's going after everyone with powers. All these magicians, all these magic conjurers. Fucking just annihilating them insanely. His fucking best friend, though, got shit on, but he did not go out like a bitch. That was amazing. That was such a cool fight. This is another series that I don't want to end, but again, Vanish seems like it can only run so much before it ends. But this issue was so good. I'm gonna give it an 8. Also, I love the art. The artwork inside here. Ryan Stegman killed it. This shit is fire. Okay, we're getting down to the last two. We were at the last three. Another Spawn variant. So the last two. This was very hard, kind of, for me. This was kind of difficult. It's Nightwing 99, number 99, by Tom Taylor. So, another Spawn variant as well. This is dope. While Nightwing's doing the bat flip, it's like him and Spawn are jumping into the fighting crime. Bro, this glare is fucking sickening. Anyways, I'll probably check post. I'll probably have them here somewhere, the variants. But, so Nightwing, that issue of Nightwing was, there wasn't like crazy action like the one before. It wasn't like the Nightmite one. This one is like, Tony Zuko, the guy who killed his fucking parents, right, is released from fucking prison and on good behavior at DK, and was gonna go try to go back to trying to do crime. He tried to get his daughter to join him. His daughter was like, no, and she changed her name. She's like, yeah, to Grayson, because she's a Grayson, actually, and she was like, no, because I think she's like running for mayor of the city of Bloodhaven. And he's like, nah, I'm not. And we're on to you, too. And Nightwing has, like, Tony Zuko's a fucking idiot. Like, Nightwing is Dick Grayson is just watching this fucker like a Hulk. Like, I'm going to see everything you're doing. I don't trust you. Good behavior, my dick. Pun intended. Because I know that you're just a bad person. He goes to like the pier where like there's like and oh my god, I'm drawing a blank of what it's called. A lighthouse. He goes to there's a lighthouse, and it's like if he was getting a club, there's like a bouncer there, but it wasn't. It was like a bank type thing. Tony Zuko has these two Asian chicks who fight come out of nowhere. Oh no, they were like his security. They uncloak themselves, beat the shit out of the guy watching the place. Tony Zuko wants something from a certain box. Shoots the guy in the face who was watching him. I think he's the quartermaster. And then steals. Of course, Nightwing, watching all this, comes, stops him. The reason why this issue was so high up there, I just love the dialogue. I love, it's refreshing to see Nightwing, just how he handles the city versus how Batman does. How he handles Bloodhaven compared to Gotham, even though Bloodhaven is like a saint city, compared a city of angels compared to fucking Gotham. Gotham is the slums of slums. Rent there should be like $200, because what the fuck. But I'm gonna give that one an 8 as well. I think I'm gonna give Nightwing an 8. My issue of the week is closing of the year for DC. Dark Crisis of Infinite Earths, Dawn of the DCU. This was 7 of 7. This was the last issue for this arc. And it brings the Dark Crisis to an end. There was so much happening. This issue was crazy. So Slade is out there, you know, with the darkness in him. This entity type force that has him so powerful that he has his daughter. He captured his daughter and Nightwing, who both have the darkness kind of in them. And he's able to use the darkness to, like, fight everybody. There's other, like, demons and other villains who are on Slade's side. And it's basically the Justice League and some villains helping to fight them off. And, no, like, it's untouchable. So Black Adam comes. First of all, I don't hate it. I dislike it sometimes, because I like it when they did it one time. I dislike when, like, publishers like DC or Marvel, Image, whatever, they draw their characters like the actors who played them in the thing. So, Black Adam looks like The Rock with hair. They did it with, they did it with The Punisher and John Bernthal. There was, like, a Punisher run called, was it Warzone? Not Warzone. It was a story arc when Punisher got the War Machine outfit, the War Machine suit, and he took on the Avengers as well. But he was working for Nick Fury. And that whole run, I think it was like a 10-issue run, Punisher was drawn to look like John Bernthal, even wore his clothes, like how John Bernthal has like his sleeves rolled up or whatever, and has that weird buzz cut. He'd look just like him. And you want to know why it bothers me that it's drawn like the character's drawn like that? Because after that story arc was finished, the next issue, which is still in the same run, he looked completely different. It felt like I was reading, even though it's another chapter, like it was another volume to Punisher, it felt like I was reading, like, because he was talking about shit that happened in the last issue and everything, but it felt like they were two different things, and it felt so weird. So it's weird, like, seeing Black Adam drawn like The Rock, because he's just gonna get drawn differently, because we're only drawing him like The Rock because The Rock had his movie. Anyways, back to this issue. Yeah, so he comes in and he starts to beat the shit out of Slade, kind of, but he knows that he has to be selfless at this moment, Black Adam. So Black Adam's just like, you know what? I'm going to fight you. I'm going to hold you off. But the Justice League and everyone else needs my help. So he gives his power, the Shazam power, to the entire League and everyone else fighting. Oh my God. While this is happening, what's her name? Dr. Light, I think it is. And the entire Flash family are trying to connect the multiverse. Because the multiverse, they're about to be destroyed. So they're, like, using the Speed Force by running to connect all of them for they don't die. So what she does with her light is she absorbs the Speed Force and releases the... That's why it's called Infinite Earths. Releases the multiverse and announces an infinite multiverse. And the people from different multiverses who were on ours, well, in this issue's thing, they had the Shazam power, and they just started going off. While Shazam doesn't have no powers now, but he's just shooting the one with Slade. Slade is beating the brakes off of him. But while this is happening, Slade is in the darkness inside of Nightwing's mind, and they're having their own fucking fight. And of course, everyone knew it was going to come down. Slade was like, of course it was going to come down to both of us. Like, oh my god. This was just so good. Oh my god, so insane. Like, look at this picture, bro. Look at this panel. Insane. Or is it where he gave all of them the ability? Oh my god. Jesus Christ. Oh my god. That was insane. Everybody with the Shazam power is wild. So yeah, so Nightwing's inside trying to fight the darkness. So yeah, Nightwing is inside fighting the darkness. The entire Justice League is fighting this army. The fucking Flash and the family are trying to connect the multiverses. Oh my god. And then they get released. They're infinite. And then Slade thinks it's over or whatever. Your boy Nightwing was like, nah. So the darkness was going to consume him. And he was just like, Nightwing let it in. Nightwing just lets, I can actually control it. Unlike Batman, who runs from the darkness and everyone else, he let the darkness be one with him. And it was over for Slade at that point. They captured him. So since the darkness was removed from him, it cured him of the serum. So he doesn't have the super soldier serum in him either. Dr. Light basically was able to stabilize all the infinite Earths. Fine. It was insane. Bro, look at it. He looks like the Rock, man, guy. Look at this one. He's even doing the people's eyebrow. Look at this one right here. Jesus Christ. That was so weird and cringe. Yeah, so there... So then... And then... So the Justice League also gets disbanded. They basically just want to stop because they were dead and they just came back to life. But Batman's like, if anyone's to lead the Justice League, it should be you, Nightwing. And Nightwing's just like, what? Mad responsibility. But he gives him his blessing and then they both go fight crime together. It ends with both of them fighting crime together. The prologue, though, of the issue is Amanda Waller talking to these people, like some council that we don't see, and she basically is going to start a war with the Justice League to take them down. She thinks that they have way too much power, blah, 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 blah. Same Amanda Waller bullshit. So it ends with that. We see some, like, panels of what's going to happen in the future of the DC for 2023. I think 2023 is going to be booming for DC if written well. Because I have Nightwing. I already know Nightwing is going to be dope. Nightwing looks like it's going to go on a great path. Batman is going to take some wild shit after this whole failsafe stuff. I've seen some stuff for, like, Superman. After picking up that issue, The Return of Kal-El, I was not, Hello? Last year's Superman, I was just like, eh. Even the Dark Crisis weird Batman thing was off to me. But Dawn, or the DCU, Infinite Earths, I'm gonna give this, sorry for the dog in the background, I'm gonna give this issue, like an 8.5. It was so good. I'm going to give it an 8.5. Pickups for next week, though. I got you right now. It's another six-issue pickup, like, this week. We got Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. With the Ninja Turtles, so it's them two combined, the crossover. DC Horror Presents Sergeant Rock versus the Army of the Dead, issue number 4. Lovesick, issue number 3, the Spawn cover. Damn Them All, issue number 3 as well. I can't wait for Damn Them All. Creepshow number 4, Spawn cover. And, Deadly Neighborhood Spider-Man number 3. Yeah, that's actually a good week. Good little pickup. So, yeah, I will see you guys next week. I will see you guys next year, technically. Hopefully I can get that on time as well, because it's also the New Year's thing. So I don't know if I will drop Monday. I might drop Tuesday or sometime in the middle of the week like I'm doing this week. And then the following week, sometime in January, I think I'm going to have two in the same week because I'm going to Dominican Republic. So I'm not going to be around for like a week. But, yeah, I'm gonna see you guys next week. That is the shit of the week. Fuck this dog.
Nah, for real. Water on me like the sun of sun. Carrots on pointers. All these commas, I won't fun. Me go gunners at the jump.